Hello everybody, welcome to the Java course. When we learn exception handling, it is usually the case that the Java virtual machine generates an exception object and then we catch it in our exception handling code. Actually, can we really create our own exception object by ourselves? Yes, we can. We can really throw an exception object by ourselves. So what does it mean by that? I'm going to tell you this idea in this video. So suppose I'm going to do simple division. So I need to create a scanner object. In doing so, I need to import the scanner class first. Okay, and then I can make use of the scanner object created here to give me two integers. And then I will do the division of these two integers. The two integers are A and B. Okay, I will give a prompt first, and then I will let the user input a certain integer to me. And the dividend will be stored in variable A. I can do the same thing for my divisor, which will be stored in variable B. And then in general, we can do the division directly by dividing A by B. And then I can say that the program is finished, and I can also close the scanner object at the end. So for this division, it is possible that the divisor is 0. What will be the case when B is actually 0 according to the user input? Let us see. Save it. Run it. The dividend can be 4, which is an integer. And how about the divisor? If I put 0, I will get the exception called arithmetic exception. The reason is that I divide one value by 0, and the exception occurs at line number 13, shown here. Okay. So we can see that the exception object is given out by the Java virtual machine. Okay. So if we want to create our own exception object like the Java virtual machine does for us, we can do something like this. We can really throw our own exception object. So I will give you an example of the creation of our own exception object. How can we do that? We can do something like this. If the divisor is equal to 0, I will simply throw an exception object whose data type is arithmetic exception, which is a subclass of the general exception class. And we have to use the new keyword here because we really want to create an arithmetic exception object. And the keyword to help me give an object is the word throw here. Okay, so if the divisor is equal to zero, I will really create my own like arithmetic exception object. And of course, we have to use the new keyword to really create an object in the Java virtual machine. Okay, if the divisor is zero, I will really throw the object of arithmetic exception data type. If the divisor is not equal to zero, the throwing action will not be executed. Instead, I'm going to do the printing, which is performed on the next line of code. Okay. So if the arithmetic exception object is really created, I need to handle it by catching it first. Now I'm going to catch an object of arithmetic exception data type, and the reference variable for that object is simply ex. So if the tripart really gives me an arithmetic exception object, the catch part followed by the tripart is able to handle it. I will simply say that your divisor fails to help me do the division correctly. Of course, I can also do the finality part. In the finality block, I simply say that you entered a valid input or your program is able to catch the exception correctly. After that, I'm going to close the scan object that I used to extract the numbers coming from the user input. So in this case, we can see the effect by running the program again. We have to take note of the try, catch, and finality parts. Especially the case when we throw our new arithmetic exception object. Save it. Run it. Suppose my dividend is 6 and my divisor is simply 2. In this case, I'm able to print out the quotient, which is simply equal to 3. Okay. And I can also do the finality block by printing the whole statement out and by closing the scanner object that I created previously. So this is the case the arithmetic exception object is not really created. But how about a situation when the divisor is equal to 0? We can see the case now by running it again. I put 7 as the dividend, 0 as the divisor. Okay, when the divisor is equal to 0, the arithmetic exception object is really created by using the new keyword, and the try block is going to throw that object to the catch block. And the catch block is able to handle the arithmetic exception object. Okay, and the object, once caught by the catch block, the catch block is able to print out the statement shown inside the catch block. It simply tells me that your divisor failed. Okay, so in this case, the arithmetic exception object can be handled by the catch block. And after the handling by the catch block, I'm able to do the finally block. So I'm going to continue my program gracefully by printing out the long statement here And I can also close the scanner object created previously here. Okay, so we can see that we can really create our own exception object by using the throw keyword together with the new keyword. And after we have created our own exception objects, we have to catch it in the catch block next to the corresponding try block. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.